I'd like to tell you a story about my lady and I. It's a true story. Well, almost true. You see, lady never was a mouse. And Saint Bernard, well, he was never a saint. And there's no way in hell I could get into heaven to get my lady. Well, I guess you'll have to pick out what is true and what is false. So, enjoy. called John the next morning, and he said he was happy to hear from me. He just happened to have a man off sick, so he could use me tomorrow night. I told Lady to get plenty of rest during the day, so she could stay awake all night. I told her that while I worked, she could play and write in the shop, and maybe we could finish our story in just one night. The graveyard shift starts at 11, and I like to be there early so I can visit my friends in the break room and find out what's gone on during the day. Usually I can find out in a few minutes more than what most of the people that have been there all day know. The best information comes straight from the horse's mouth, and the best place to get it is where the horse has his oats. A few minutes in the break room and I know everything I need to know about the who's, where's, and when's and why's that cover the events of the day. Although it prepares me for most surprises, there's always something new and unusual that arises. That's why I love the job so much, because no matter how well you're prepared, something new and different will happen. I love it when I can solve a new, unexpected dilemma. This is when a miracle took place. The child broke from the man, jumped back on the roof, and when the man tried to retrieve the child, I was on him like a hawk on its prey. This all took just 20 minutes into my shift. I'd forgotten about Lady who was still in my pocket. I reached in and got her with a sigh of relief and said, "Thank God, my dear lady, you're safe. Come on, girl, let's go down to the shop so you can run around a little bit." The phone was ringing when we got down to the shop. It was the PBX operator. She said that she'd been trying to get me for the last 20 minutes and that she had several calls that all needed immediate attention. I told her that I was sorry, but due to an emergency, I had been unable to pick up a radio yet. She said that the guest in 526 had lost the key to her suitcase and needed it opened ASAP. Guest in 819 was really angry because his TV quit working right in the middle of his favorite movie. And the guest in 729 had a 1099. A 1099 is a plugged-up toilet. And the kitchen cleanup crew was having a fit because there was a broken pipe spraying water all over the place. I hung up the phone with a grin on my face and a little bit of a chuckle. I said, "Well, lady, looks like I'm back where I belong." I had retired a few months ago, and up until now I haven't realized how much I miss this place. I said, "Lady, make yourself at home here in the shop while I go take care of these problems. When I get back, we'll talk about the book that we're going to write."